So at the University of Leeds, mechanical engineering, there's something very special going on. You may remember this team from last year. Using LabVIEW and Compact Rio, they developed a haptic feedback system that was used to detect tumors. Well, they are at it again, this time working very closely with local hospitals and doctors to give their students very relevant projects that are helping the local community.
My name's Bipin Bhakta. I'm a Charterhouse Professor in Rehabilitation Medicine, and my role at the hospital is to provide clinical services for people, largely with neurological conditions such as stroke, but we also are involved in the care of children with disabilities such as cerebral palsy. And the feedback I get from my engineering colleagues and the students is that it's been a very useful exercise working with clinicians, not just doctors, but also therapists. And more importantly, my impression was that the engineering students found working with patients and their families very rewarding, because a lot of these students hadn't come across real patients before. And so developing technologies for people, for patients who might need to use them without actually having a first-hand experience of the patient's problems seems to be developing technologies a bit in a vacuum.
Please welcome, from the University of Leeds School of Mechanical Engineering, Professor Martin Leavesley and Dr. Pete Colmer, along with their students, Barney Cotter, Dominic Clark, and Chris Norman.
People try to put us down.
Good morning. All right. Good morning, guys. Good morning. All right. Good morning. Good morning. Good morning. All right.
So now, I understand you guys brought some new hardware today.
Oh yeah, we did. Day one, the Graphical Systems Design Award, we found out that our students had actually won the student design competition. So we bought something to show off, to show.
Great, congratulations.
So, look at that, bit of our
great
own
job. Great job, man, that's great.
But it didn't quite stop there We've got another bit of hardware. We also won the Humanitarian Award.
Wow.
And this was for our work with the heart simulator.
Great. So. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Good job, guys.
Thank you.
Good. That's great.
One more.
Oh, okay.
We also found that we'd also won the Life Science Award. One we're very proud
of.
Wow,
that's great. Looks like you've got a bronze, silver, and gold here. That's great, guys. that's fantastic.
Hang on. One more. At the end of the evening, we also found out that we'd won the overall category as well.
Wow.
We're really chuffed with this. That's never won this one before.
All right. Well, how about you tell the audience how you won all these awards?
Yeah, okay. About 4 years ago then, I came to NI Week for the first time, and I've been back every year ever since. And at that time, we're working what sounds like a bit of a crazy project we called IPAM. And what we were trying to do is to develop a robot that would help us deliver physiotherapy to people that had suffered stroke. Now, as engineers, we're kind of used to building robot systems, and for safety, we keep them a bit back from people. But in this application, we needed to attach the robots directly to the arms of the patients. We also found out at this time that we'd won some awards from the UK government to develop the next generation of IPAMs, and also to develop a system that we could use with children with cerebral palsy. We wanted to use this one not in hospitals, but in their homes and in schools. Now, as you can imagine then, safety in these applications is absolutely crucial, so is reliability. But fortunately, I'd got to see the potential for Compact Rio and LabVIEW at a closed door session here in Austin. And well, we decided to take a bit of a gamble on the technology. Fortunately, things worked out for us, and we found that using industry standard tools such as LabVIEW and Compact Rio really helped when it came for us to get regulatory approval for these robot systems to be used as medical devices in trials. So now, currently, pleased to say, a couple of years later, we have three next-generation IPAMs currently out in hospitals in England and in Scotland. And we're also conducting trials of the robot system in the homes and schools of children with cerebral palsy. And the kids, well, they just love it. Now, on the teaching side then, at that time, we also had some pretty ambitious plans to try and introduce more really exciting sort of hands-on design and build projects earlier in the sort of student's career. And we wanted to be able to build on these sort of real-world examples later on in their sort of senior courses as well. Here, again, the choice of using Compact Rio just turned out to be a no-brainer. But this time, perhaps because, or perhaps more because of the durability. I mean, after all, it was going to be our students that were using these systems. So.
Right. Now, Dr. Comer, you were a student of Dr. Lively as well, right?
Yeah, that's right. It feels like a long time ago now. I think I was using LabVIEW V5. It must have been a good experience because I came back to study a PhD at Leeds, and now I work there with Martin. So I teach LabVIEW to our undergraduate students in their first year. I run robotics projects with the students, and I'm continuing my research into healthcare technologies. And we've got some really exciting projects going on at the moment. We've got CCAT, which is a tablet PC running LabVIEW, and this provides clinicians with a really easy and convenient tool to use to identify and assess children with movement impairment. It's been piloted in local schools with over 500 children, and we're extending this to thousands more in the next few years. Then we've got MyPAM, a portable version of the IPAM system that Martin mentioned before. So here we use single board Rio and LabVIEW to provide a really kind of compact system that was reliable and could be deployed in the homes of kids with cerebral palsy or adults with stroke to improve their arm movement. We've continued our work on the haptic simulation system. Earl and James, the students on the project, are now back with us doing PhDs. And they're looking at ways that we can provide improved and additional information to surgeons to improve their operative performance. And then we have the IVAD, the award-winning IVAD. So this is a really impressive piece of kit. You might have seen this down on the robotics pavilion. If not, I'd encourage you to go and have a look. So this uses Compact Rio and LabVIEW to provide a full hardware-in-the-loop simulation of the human heart. And it can represent different heart conditions, and it's been used to prototype an intelligent heart assist device and reduce the need for animal testing. Now, I shouldn't forget that we've got the student projects. So this year, Martin and I tasked our students to produce a rehabilitation assessment tool. Now, motion tracking systems that are commonly used to do this can be quite bulky, lab-based, and very expensive. So what we did is we asked them to provide a low-cost, portable solution using the Microsoft Kinect. I won't steal their thunder anymore. I'll let the guys here explain.
Sure. So the Kinect gives us an easy way to track a patient's movement without having to attach markers to the body. Essentially, it's just like videoing with a camera, except we can extract 3D data of their joint positions. So from this, we can infer how far, how fast, or how smoothly a patient's moving. Now, this information is really important to physiotherapists and clinicians, as it gives them a better insight into how well a patient's doing and how far they are in the rehab. Now, LabVIEW was really good in this project. It allowed us to easily integrate the code with the Kinect hardware and visualize the data.
We started off by developing a LabVIEW toolkit for the Kinect so we could test its capabilities. After seeing the value of the toolkit, we wanted to share and make it available with other LabVIEW users via the LabVIEW Tools Network. So, Ray, everyone in this room, everyone in the world, in fact, can go and download and install our toolkit, and best of all, it's free.
All right, thanks, guys. Appreciate that. I was talking to someone on the show floor just a couple of days ago that was interested and was going to download the toolkit. So tell us, how does the toolkit impact your application?
Well, we interviewed clinicians to gain an understanding as to how the Kinect could help with medical diagnosis and immediately started developing applications. So we're going to develop two of them here for you today.
Suffering a stroke often leaves people with severe motor impairments. So our first demo is focused on upper limb stroke rehabilitation. It's a system patients could take and use in their own home. Now, let's take a look. Ray, if you could just stand in front of the Kinect.
Okay.
Okay. Now, as you can see, we've used LabVIEW's 3D picture control to create a virtual environment, complete with a series of balls. The user then has to touch these with their virtual hands, and we can observe and track their progress on the right. Whilst it looks simple, this kind of repetitive grabbing motion is essential in providing traditional stroke rehabilitation, as it's something they find very hard to do. Additionally, it gives us an objective and effective way of evaluating and recording their performance.
Fly like a bee.
So, Ray, how are you
like a bee.
How are you finding it?
Okay, so we got a second demo, right?
So our second demo is a full movement analysis system for the Kinect in LabVIEW. So you could use this to analyze arm movements or evaluate how a person walks. There are two parts of the system. First, we take a recording with the Kinect. Then, we take measurements and analyze the movements. So here's an example we recorded earlier. So, as you can see here, you can, at the top, you can change the selected video, the length of the video, save the current selection as a .avi file, or loop the playback. We've also got full 3D skeleton mapping, an RGB video, and you can also analyze different joint parameters such as position, velocity, or acceleration, analyze one of the 20 different joints, and view it in the X, Y, or Z axes.
All right, that's great, guys. Well, thank you for coming out today, and congratulations on sweeping all of the awards this week. Thank you. Thank you.
Cheers, Robert.